Greetings from a very dark and a very cold Rome Fiumicino airport. Not a very interesting one today. We're simply flying EasyJet from here at Rome to London Luton. Nice and empty, thankfully, Terminal 3. Partly empty because it's a late flight. We're leaving at, well, supposed to be 9:45 p.m. but it's already been delayed 45 minutes, so we're going to see what's going on. They've told us to just come to the airport, do everything as normal. So we're just waiting for the special assistance at the moment to arrive for the family. We're flying from Rome Fiumicino Terminal 3 to my absolutely god-awful London Luton Airport with EasyJet on there, you know, normal ticket, nothing special, nothing snazzy. Airbus A320, no Neo today, sadly, but we are on Romeo Zulu, which is only 1.5 years old. So we'll have those slimline fabric seats. Row 11, so we'll get some nice views outside of the engine. So we're gonna probably be heading to security very shortly. So join me, thank you for watching. I'm gonna do all the normal YouTube stuff now. Subscribe, share, comment. Security all done. Nice and easy actually, but I'll give you my thoughts on the airport in a moment when I can find a quiet spot that no one will start judging me. Okay, what can I say? I love the terminal. The terminal is absolutely fantastic. The architecture's brilliant. There's a ton of shops, albeit a lot of them are all very like designer wear. So you can't really make the most of it unless you've got about £1 billion to spend. What else? Security, that was quite nice. Not much to complain about. I mean, it's always gonna be a bit busy. And sometimes the Italians are quite known for not being particularly efficient, but they did an all right job today. Probably took me about 5 minutes from start to end, so I'll take that as a security. Not quite as good as some of the other European airports, but still quite good nonetheless. Plenty of food up here. I'm probably gonna go and grab a pizza myself at some point. And yeah, not much to really report on. We've had about a 45 minute delay, so I'm just gonna be kind of waiting around a bit. Went to the Ferrari shop, bought my dad a little, some little Ferrari espresso mugs, which should all be well received. So in the meantime, just gonna chill out, enjoy the terminal, because I'm loving the architecture. It reminds me quite a bit of Dubai, so that's always a good thing. There's a very excited me ready to board, where we were greeted by a particularly disorderly boarding queue. Passengers were basically not playing by the rules. Anyway, we boarded through a jet bridge, which was quite a nice touch. We were greeted by some very, very friendly cabin crew and a beautiful cabin. The clean floors, sleek cabin design and bright LED cabin lighting could make you think that you're on a full service airline, were it not for the fact that, well, you're obviously not on a full service airline because there's advertisements and lots of orange.
I think we have to. let's take a look at some of the bits and bobs in the seat back pocket. This is a voiceover because I'm worried that people will look at me like I'm a complete and utter weirdo. You do get a lovely menu with a massive selection of hot and cold drinks, which can be purchased individually by cash and card in loads of different currencies. And you can also combine them to make what they call a meal deal, which is hardly a deal, for £7.50. You also get a lovely safety card with lots of, well, safety things. As well as the Traveller magazine, which is a pretty good read. You get loads of information about the airlines and ask the pilot bit, and some bits and bobs about cities that they go to, which does keep you occupied. I love reading it. And if you are one that does need to get sick, you have a sick bag.
Do you have to let it wait for 5 minutes?
Yeah. All right. Buon appetito. Right, now behold the toilet tour. Approaching Luton, it's probably a good time to sum up what I thought of this short EasyJet hop from Rome. Let's start off with the cabin crew. They had a pretty difficult job today. The flight from Luton turned out to be delayed due to an unruly passenger, and there were also some passengers on this flight that were causing some trouble. Some of them had too many bags and were in the priority lane when they weren't supposed to be, and they were causing a couple of problems for dispatch and the cabin crew. The legroom on this Airbus A320 is 29 inches of seat pitch, which, considering their route network, are very, very rarely over 4 hours, the longest being to Tel Aviv, which is about 5 hours, it will do the job. There is nicer out there, but then you have to pay for a full service airline. So considering that you are on a low cost carrier, the legroom is nothing to complain about. If you would like extra legroom, you can purchase that on row one, which I did show earlier on, for an extra £17.99. In-flight catering, the soup I had was quite nice. Nothing to complain about on that front. Most of them are all pretty famous brands which they sell, so nothing too dodgy. Although it was quite steep, it did cost a lot, but you are eating on an aircraft, so what can you expect? So overall, would I fly with EasyJet again? Yes, I have been for the past 15 years, because although, you know, they're not perfect, what do you expect? If you're paying a very reasonable fare and you have flight club status like our family, why would you go and spend the extra money on such a short hop? So yeah, thumbs up from me.
At the front, row 11, and on the way here we had the 390, and I noticed that the slats were down a bit more first time, so when I saw you were landing with the slats, I was like, oh, it might be a comfy 3.
Yeah, that was a flat 3 landing.
Yeah. Was it flex takeoff?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Almost all of our takeoffs flex.
You don't need anything on a runway that long.
Well,
it's the GBWS systems turn up.
Terrain awareness test start.
That's fantastic. That is brilliant. And the fire extinguisher?
Terrain awareness LRU passed. Required external input failed. Terrain awareness system failed. Terrain awareness test complete.
That's brilliant. I loved it. Yeah, I always think
they're the best takeoffs when you hold on the brakes. Alright, that's a wrap. EasyJet Economy, Rome to London Luton. Thank you so very much for watching, guys. I do hope you enjoyed it. Please comment as to what you think of EasyJet, if you've had any interesting experiences you'd like to share, and also do like, comment, and share the video. And until next time, folks, happy flighting!